Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips. Today I'll be showing you how to emphasize freckles and add a dim Moody effect in Photoshop. I don't remember exactly where I saw this effect, but I do remember seeing someone asking about it in the postprocessing subreddit, and I thought that it'd be a nice tutorial, especially for beginners who don't have much experience with Photoshop. It's an easy effect, and you'll be learning how to do this with a very minimal and non-destructive set of layers. We're going to start by enhancing the freckles. There's a couple ways to enhance freckles in Photoshop. In the past, I taught people how to use the yellow channel to hide or enhance freckles, and it works very well. If you want to learn how to do that, it's in one of my older videos, and you can find the link by clicking on the info card on the top right corner. But for this video, I'll show you another way of doing it that's simpler, faster, and still gives you great results. Here's how to do it. In the Adjustments panel, add a Channels Adjustment layer. If you don't see this panel, you can open it by going to Window, Adjustments. In the Properties panel, start by checking the Monochrome option, which will make this layer black and white. Next, set the reds to -50, greens to -50, and blues to 200. You can also adjust the constant slider here if you need to adjust the brightness. And as you can see with this black and white layer, it's really emphasizing and bringing out the freckles. Next, change the blending mode of this layer to luminosity, and then adjust the opacity. Now when we turn on and off this layer, you can see that it's really emphasizing the freckles. If you only want this layer to affect the skin, you can paint in the layer mask. Start by selecting the layer mask in the layers panel, and then press Ctrl or Command I to invert it to black. Select your brush tool, make sure your foreground color is white, and then paint over the areas where you want the effect to appear. Next, we're going to add an effect that gives it a dim and warm effect using the tone curves, which is the most efficient way of doing this. For this tutorial, the tone curves we're going to apply is very simple and easy, so you don't need to fully understand the tool to be able to follow along. But if you have the time, I highly recommend watching the tone curves video in the info card on the top right corner. The tone curves is the most useful adjustment for photographers, and you can find it in pretty much every image editing software like Lightroom, Affinity Photo, Capture One, and even some mobile apps like Snapseed and Lightroom Mobile. So here's how to add the effect. In the Adjustments panel, add a Curves Adjustment layer. Here we're going to start with the RGB channel. Drag the top right point downwards like this to dim the image. Next, click on the middle part of the chart and add a point right in the center. This will restore the brightness while keeping the dim look. Next, click on the drop-down menu and switch to a blue channel. For a lot of people, the red, green, and blue tone curves is where people get the most confused. And for those of you who don't know how to use the tone curves, here's an easy way to understand how it works. Imagine the tone curves like this. This isn't actually what it looks like in Photoshop, but imagine that it does. And keep this image in your head as you're adjusting. It'll make things so much easier. So if you go to a blue channel, and drag the top right point downwards like this, it'll tint the highlights yellow. Next, lift the bottom left point upwards like this to tint a very tiny amount of blues in the shadows. And we're done! Here's how the image looks like before and after this adjustment. Using the tone curves is the best way to keep your layers minimal. To complete this image, we're going to add a simple lighting effect with just one gradient fill layer. In the Layers panel, click on the New Fill or Adjustment Layer button here and select Gradient Fill. By the way, you won't find this in the Adjustments panel because it's technically a fill layer and not an adjustment layer. In the Gradient Fill options, select the Black to White gradient. If you don't see this, you can click on the cogwheel icon and select Reset Gradients. Next, set the Style to Radial and checkmark the Reverse option. Adjust the scale to however large you want it to be. I'll set mine to about 150%. Click OK when you're done. We now have a gradient, and to make it blend in with your photo, change the blending mode to soft light. I'm going to move this layer below the curves adjustment layer so it doesn't override the tone curves that we made earlier. Now we can reposition the light. To do this, double click on the thumbnail to readjust the gradient fill setting. Click and drag on your document and you'll notice that the light moves around wherever your mouse is. I'm going to position mine around here, and I'm also going to readjust the scale to enlarge the gradient. We're done! If we turn on and off this layer, you can see that it changes the lighting a lot. Unlike a traditional vignette, this gradient overlay can be repositioned anywhere, and it's a great way to add focus to your photo. Here's how the image looks like before and after. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I used a stock photo for this video, and it's obviously for demonstration purposes only. But how good this effect looks really depends on what photo you use it with and your personal preference. Also, I recommend that you start off with a stronger effect, similar to what I did in this video, because if you want to make the effect weaker, you can always just lower the opacity. Anyways, thank you again so much for watching. And if you subscribe to my channel, thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. Please remember to like this video if you liked it, and I'll see you again next week.